Hi guys, this is JJ here, and I'm really happy to see you over here. I just recently gave the GRE and scored a perfect 117 quants. I did it, and I believe so can you. So in this video, we'll go about which books to refer for quants, how much preparation time you need to give in, what should be the test taking strategy, and the number of mocks you must attempt. So this is it, let's start point by point. The first pertinent question is, why is it really, really important to score exceptionally well in quants? Now, for all those people who are pursuing engineering courses, who want to pursue engineering courses for their MS, your quants is much, much more important than your verbal. Of course, there is a minimum requirement for your verbal score, but it is your quant score which the admission committee looks at. So, scoring a 170 will give you a 97th percentile. The chart is displayed on the left-hand side. You can look at it. Scoring a 169 will drop the percentile to 96. So that means that 4% people are ahead of you. If you score 165, not much less than 170, only 5 points less, maybe you have got 5 questions wrong, so it is 165, but your percentile drastically drops to 89 percentile. And 1% is a huge, huge margin. A lot of test takers all over the world take GRE, and 1% therefore consists of a huge lot of students. So someone who has a percentile which is 94 or 97 would definitely have a good chance of securing admission at the college you are applying. So maybe the difference is not more, it's just 165 and 170, only 5 points, but the difference in percentile is huge. So this is the first thing you need to understand. You got 5 wrong and you got 3 wrong. There is a huge difference. So what you need to do in quants is attempt that you get a 170 or maybe a 169. I wouldn't suggest that, but 170 would be perfect. So this is the first scenario of percentile which you should keep in mind. Your one wrong question will cost you severely. Now let's understand GRE as an adaptive test. GRE is a section-wise adaptive test. There are two sections in quants. The first section is of moderate difficulty. In each section, you will have to answer 20 questions. So in the first section, which is of moderate difficulty, if you answer 16 or more questions correctly, the second section which you will get would be a harder one, the difficult section. If you answer somewhere in between 10 to 15 questions correct, the second section would be of moderate difficulty. So the difficulty level of your first section and the second section would be the same. However, which should not be your case, if you answer 10 or less than 10 correct, you will get a significantly easier set as your second section. But this doesn't mean that if you get all the questions right in your second section, you have a chance of scoring high. In fact, it is opposite of that. With every section which is adapted, maybe it is easier, moderate, or difficult, your total marks are limited. So if you want to score 170 or maybe more than 165, first of all, you need to score well in your first section so that the next section you get is a difficult one. And if you want to score 170, the concept is really, really simple. You need to get 20 questions correct in your first section, and when the test adapts to the difficult section, you again need to get the same amount of questions correct. And it is pretty simple, then you can get a perfect 170. Now there is some site called brightlinkprep.com which gives you an estimate, or roughly an estimate, which are not the official figures, but which gives you an estimate of how much your score can be if you attend X number of correct questions in the first section and if you do Y number of correct questions in the second section. So the link for that and all other prep material and all other stuff which we would be discussing in the video will be down in the description. So you can check that in the description. Now let's discuss the best books for preparation. Now there are a lot of books in the market, but this is not the video for the pros and cons of each. Right now, what you should know is the ultimate preparation books. So the complete and exhaustive preparation you will get is from the two books. Number one, which you should start with, is the Manhattan 5LB. Now there are four types of questions you will encounter in your GRE. Number one is the quantitative comparisons questions. Number two, the regular MCQ questions. Number three, multiple answer correct questions. So now in the third type of questions, you will have five options, and from those five options, maybe two are right, one is right, or maybe all five are right. So you need to be careful while attempting this type of question. And the number four question is inputting the answer. For these questions, you would not have the options, but whatever your answer is, you would have to input it in the box which is given to you. Now, all these types of questions are covered exhaustively in Manhattan 5LB. There are 30 topics for quants, which is a lot to do. So you can do each topic a day. So in 30 days, you can complete all the things. So the preparation is quite complete if you solve each and every problem of quants from Manhattan 5LB. Once you are done with that, then you need to go to the ETS official subject guide of quants. So this book is a small book. The number of questions are not many, but this is very important to get the real feel of the type of questions which you would get in the exam. So this book you can complete in 4 days. And after you complete both of these books, you require no other test material. You can directly go to attempting mocks and scoring your dream score of 170. The most important part of the video is right here, the test taking strategies. Now, generally, there are two schools of attempting the test sections. So you have 20 questions and 35 minutes to attempt the section. The number one is play it slow, play it safe. I actually do not recommend this, but I would like to tell you what it is. Play it slow. So this actually means that in the 35 minutes which are allotted to you to solve 20 questions, you use around 30 to 32 minutes to solve each question slowly, safely, double checking your answer whether it is right or not. So you end up using 30 to 32 minutes, and you have no time to go to the questions again. Now, if you are pretty confident that all of your answers are correct, then this may work for you. But this is certainly what I wouldn't recommend. The second school of thinking is what I would recommend. Play it fast and play it twice. Now, fast doesn't actually mean play it risky. Number one, what you should do is leave the questions which you don't know when you read it for the first time. All the questions which you know for the first time when you read it, attempt those questions. Those questions would get solved in around 35 to 50 seconds. The questions which you don't know, please don't attempt them at the first chance. So from the 20 questions, there are 15 questions you can definitely solve in the first attempt. Now there are some 5 questions which are difficult and which would take around 2 to 2.5 minutes. Not all the questions would take around 2 to 2.5 minutes, but definitely some of them would do. So for that 5 questions, you have 10 minutes in hand. So what I used to do with practice and practice was that I used to solve the first 10 questions in first 15 questions, which were the easier ones from the 20, in around 12 to 13 minutes. And then the 5 questions which were difficult or which I wouldn't get in the first attempt of reading, I would allot 10 minutes to it. I would require 10 minutes to it. And in such a scenario, I was completing the 20 questions in around 22 to 23 minutes. So right now I have 12 more minutes in my hand. So what I would like to do is play it twice. Go through all the questions twice. First of all, mark the questions which you think that you should go again. So first go through those questions and again, all of the questions. So by using this strategy, you're quite sure that all of your questions are correct. And with practice, this is very easily possible. I would like to give you a note on ideal time of preparation. I would like to tell you one thing, that GRE is not your life. It is just another exam. I've seen people preparing for it for 6 months, 1 year. Absolutely ridiculous. You should not allot more time than 2 months for preparing to your GRE because it doesn't require it. Specifically speaking, you should give in around 150 to 180 hours for your preparation. When I was preparing for GRE, for the first month, I gave 2 hours daily. So that accounted for 60 hours. And in the last 15 days, I used to solve mocks in 4 hours and used to give 4 hours for the mock analysis and revising all my concepts throughout the days. So for the 15 days, I studied 8 hours a day. So that around approximately goes to 160 to 180 hours. Now, the number of mocks you should give. Number of mocks, ideally, I think it would vary from 4 to 6. I gave 6 mocks and I was comfortable with it. Anything above 6, I would think that it will tire you out, and that is not a recommendation because the same concepts would be coming again and again. You would be solving the same sums, and 6 mocks, which each mock is of 4 hours, so it is quite tiring. So 6 mocks is the maximum you should give. And after that, just chill for a week or so. Just revise your concepts. Just go through your vocabulary, brush up your concepts. A week before GRE, you should do absolutely nothing, just brush up your concepts and go to the GRE. And hopefully, you'll be able to score a perfect 117 quants. Just do what I've said, and all the best for you. Oh, one last thing. If this video has helped you a bit, or if this video have gave you an insight on how to prepare for GRE, don't forget to give a thumbs up, subscribe, click the bell icon, and most importantly, share this important video to all of your friends. Thank you. Hey there, still here? It's nice. I just wanted to make a small announcement. The most important resource for your GRE preparation are the two mocks given by ETS. ETS gives you the mocks, but it doesn't give you the solution. But why were even I'm here? I'm making videos on the solutions of the ETS mocks, the most important resource to you. For that, you need to get the notifications. So down there, click subscribe and click the bell icon. Bye-bye!